Getting a glimpse of the sweetest people on earth. How about the guys on the band? Hey, so anyway, here I am. This is like 2 miles from where I played high school baseball. I'm gonna play a quick game of catch. We have to talk later. Most of these songs that I'm going to play tonight, I think you'll be familiar with, and maybe a few that you'll be less so. But the rhythm tunes, they're all written with the idea that you'd get up and dance. So since you're all up, I guess you can dance anytime you want. Yeah, it's home with you, and here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, from Austin. says this is Joel Guzman. Chords of the songs that I was listening to on the radio. Turns out they all had the same chords pretty much. They're like, and I wrote not a whole bunch of songs, just like hundreds of kids on street corners around New York around that time. And then I don't know what happened somewhere towards the end of that decade, and I'm talking about the 50s. Somewhere around that time, like, rock and roll got real stupid. And maybe because it was so brilliant in the middle of the decade, so much energy and heart. Anyway, I traded in my electric guitar and I got my first acoustic guitar, and I moved to England, and there I was on like kind of the folk circuit there, and that's where I learned to Travis pick. And I used to write these songs that make up a little guitar lick at the top of a song. By the 70s, I was thinking I could write these songs on guitar, but I don't have to record them on guitar. I could transpose it and have them on piano. So here comes Bridge Over Troubled Water, Still Crazy After All These Years, songs like that. And anyway, you get the point. I'm not going to go through every decade, you know. And in the early 2000s. A couple of years ago, though, I was working on finishing an album, trying to think of like what song I'm going to do, and I said, hey, you know, well, I like this sound here, just like this, and I like this tempo. Now I just need a guitar line to start it off. Thank you. That's right. I'm gonna change the name. These songs, I really never think about characters that, you know, continue from one song to another, from one album to another. But I realized recently that the old guy working at the car wash in the song, he's the same kid who got on the bus in America. It's my generation. Anyway, to Kingston, Jamaica. California in the early 80s with Joan Baez. And we were practicing a duet, and it was at her house, and she had to leave and take a phone call. And so I took a book down from the shelves, and it was the great surrealist painter René Magritte. And so I looked at the book and come upon this photograph that said René and Georgette Magritte with their dog after the war. And I said to myself, what a great title for a song. What can this all possibly be about? Could be about fireworks, because that's can't really ignore the fireworks. Because you're holding up those fireworks and trying to tell a story about what they were doing. Anyway, so I said, well, I can write this song about pretty much anything because it's a surrealist painter, so it's a surreal situation. Look at this thing. So I started to write the song, and I included these R&B vocal groups that I love so much from the 50s. The Penguins, the Moonglows, the Orioles, the Five Satins. Put them all together, and that's how René and Georgette Magritte came to be.
Oh.
to New York City group, Wild Music. I have a strange relationship to this next song. I wrote it a long time ago. And when I finished it, I said to myself, that's better than I usually do. and then I gave it away, and I didn't sing it for a long time. Occasionally, I try it on tours, but I never actually felt like it was mine, because the original versions were so unique. But this being a final tour, I'm going to reclaim my lost child. I suffered a great loss this year when our amazing guitarist from Cameroon, Vincent Guinea, passed away last December. Vincent was on every album from the Rhythm of the Saints up until In the Blue Light, which just came out. And I couldn't have written many of those songs without Vincent's rhythmic sense and harmonic, just his inspiration and his soul. I really despaired that we would be able to play any of those songs as a band. But fortunately, Mark Stewart, yeah, and Jamie Haddad, they met a very gifted musician from Nigeria. This is Biodun Kuti, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know whether Biodun is communicating with Vincent, or Vincent is talking directly to Bee, but somehow there's an intense conversation that seems to be continuing that maybe began long ago in the West African soil. Anyway, it's brought a great energy back to our group, and now we're going to do a song from the Rhythm of the Saints album. This is Spirit Voices. This hat's my walking around town hat. It's the E on here stands for half earth. It's The Half Earth Foundation was founded by a renowned scientist named E.O. Wilson, Edward Wilson. I'm glad some of you know who he is. And he wrote this book, Half Earth, about 2 years ago, and I was very inspired by it. And I went to work for this foundation, and last tour I did, I just gave all the money to Half Earth, and essentially what the book says is it lays out a plan to ecologically save our planet. So, if you're interested, Edward Wilson, Google him up, and the Half Earth Foundation, and there are other groups that are, you know, equally involved in saving our planet. The Nature Conservancy is one, and there are many that we have. This song is called Questions for the Angels. It's really all about the last verse.
Are you ready? Oh, my love lies waiting silently for me.
my songs again. Play the key of the tune. All my words come back to me. Shades in the empty, emptiness and harmony. I need someone to comfort me.
Thank you.
clear as there's a box in front of an ice tree, and it carries the reminders of every blow that laid him down on the front row till he cried out. And his anger and shame are leaving, are leaving, but the fire's still burning, still on the ice.
I turn my collar to the cold.
is the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people there. People talking without speaking. People hearing without singing. People writing songs that voices never share. No one dared disturb the sound of silence. I do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words and I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach out to you. But my words like silent raindrops fell. People bowed and prayed to the neon body man. And the sign flashed its warning, and the words that it was for me said, the words of the prophets are written on the subway.
More than you can.